This class we work out one problem on fast decoupled load flow method. Given power system network is a 3 bus system. Bus 1 is a slack bus. Voltage is 1.05 V1. Delta 1 is equal to 0. Bus 2 is a load bus. Real power load is 400 MW. Reactive power load is 250 MV ampere reactive. Bus 3 is a PV bus, generator bus. Real power generation is 200 MW, V3 is 1.04. Reactive power limit is given, Q3 minimum is 0, maximum is 1.5 per unit, base MVA is equal to 100, line series admittances are given. Step 1, set the calculator in the radiant mode, form a Y-bus matrix. This is a Y-bus matrix of the system. This is the magnitude, this is in radians. Second step, initialize the bus voltages and load angles. V1 is equal to 1.05, delta 1 is equal to 0, V2 we have to assume 1 per unit, delta 2 is equal to 0, V3 is equal to 1.04, delta 3 is equal to 0. Third step, calculate P2, P3, Q2, Q3 using this formula, that is the static load flow equations. P2 is equal to minus 1.162, Q2 is equal to minus 2.269, P3 is equal to 0.543, Q3 is equal to 1.025. The Q3 limit is given 0, minimum, maximum is 1.5. Calculator Q3 value is within the limits, hence bus 3 acts as a generator bus or a PV bus. That is the step 4. Step 5, calculate the difference in real and reactive power. Here P2 is equal to PG minus PL. Here generation is 0. PL is 400 MW. 400 by 100, that is equal to 4. 0 minus 4 is equal to minus 4 per unit. So difference in P2 is equal to minus 4 minus calculated minus 1.162. That is equal to minus 2.838 per unit. P3 is equal to PG minus PL, generation is 200, 200 by 100, 2 minus, calculator is 0.543, that is equal to 1.457 per unit. Q2 is equal to QG minus QL, QG is 0, minus, this is 250 MW, 250 by 100, 2.5, that is minus 2.5 per unit. Delta Q2 is equal to minus 2.5 minus calculator minus 2.269, that is equal to minus 0.231 per unit. Step 6, compute B dash matrix. First we have to form a susceptance matrix. Eliminate the conductance value in the admittance matrix, we got a susceptance matrix. From the susceptance matrix we can calculate B dash matrix. Eliminate the slack bus related susceptance values, we got a B dash matrix. B dash matrix is equal to minus B22, minus B23, minus B32, minus B33. So B dash matrix is equal to 52 minus 32 minus 32, 62. B dash inverse is 0.028, 0.015, 0.015, 0.024. Step 7, calculate change in delta 2, change in delta 3. So B dash inverse matrix into change in P2 by modulus of V2, we assume V2 is equal to 1. Change in P3 divided by modulus of V3, V3 is equal to 1.04 given. Now we can easily calculate change in delta 2 is equal to minus 0.058. Change in delta 3 is equal to 0.0089. Step 8, calculate B double dash matrix. In the given power system, bus 1 is a slack bus, bus 3 is a PV bus, bus 2 is a load bus. We have to calculate the change in V2, therefore we have to choose B double dash is equal to minus B22, we have to take this value. Minus into minus plus 52. Ninth step, we can calculate change in V2. Change in V2 is equal to B double dash inverse matrix into del Q2 by modulus of V2. Modulus of V2 is equal to 1, we assume. Del Q2 is equal to minus 0.231 by 1 divided by 52, that is equal to minus 0.004. 10th step, compute new bus voltages and load angles. First iteration delta 2 value is initial values plus change. Initial value is 0 minus 0.058. That is equal to minus 0.058. First iteration delta 3 value is initial value 0 plus change in delta 3. That is equal to 0.0089. So, first iteration delta 3 is 0.0089. Similarly, first iteration V2 value is initial value plus change. Initial value is 1. Change is minus 0.004. First iteration V2 value is 0.996. The calculator V2, delta 2 and delta 3. We have to use these new values in the second iteration. This way you have to repeat the problem till the convergence. So with this I conclude my lecture. Thanks for listening.